Hey everybody, this is Nakić-Alfirević from QueryStorm. So a while ago, I worked on a project that involved scraping some data from a public dataset, analyzing it locally, and then pushing results into Monday.com so that the rest of the team can have access to important metrics. Specifically, it was for a healthcare provider in the UK where they wanted to benchmark their results against the national averages and the regional averages. So how do we do that? Well, Monday.com isn't really a BI tool. You can't access external data from Monday.com. You can't store a lot of data. You can't even process a lot of data inside Monday.com. So basically what you have to do is pull in the data locally, analyze it, create aggregate results, and then push just those results into Monday.com. Once the results are there and in a particular shape, Monday.com can do a decent job of visualizing the data via various charts and graphs. So in this video, I'm going to keep things simple. I'm going to start with a simple CSV file, and I'm going to use it to populate a Monday.com dashboard with several charts. I'm using a CSV file for simplicity, but if I was using a database or an API, the process would be very similar. The example CSV file has data on some popular movies, including data about actors, release year, director, gross revenue, and so on. I'm going to process the data locally on my machine using Power Query, and I'm going to upload the results to Monday.com using MondayLink. Okay, let's have a look at what we're trying to achieve. We'll start with this graph that shows earnings by genre over time. To plot this graph, we need data shaped something like this. We have a row for each decade, and the values for each genre are in separate columns, so we can plot them as separate lines on the graph. Our data source is a CSV file with about 1,000 rows. We don't want to push the entire dataset to Monday.com because we can't process it there. Instead, we want to process it locally using Power Query and then push just the results into Monday.com. The source data could get updated in the future, so I'm going to want to keep my queries in a separate Excel file, and I'm going to use the CSV file as my data source. Let's take another look at the graph we're going to populate. We're going to aggregate the data by decade and calculate the earnings for each genre in separate columns. Let's see if we can do that with Power Query. We have a release year for each movie, and we can easily calculate the decade from there using the mod function. The genre columns are going to be a bit more tricky though, because all of the genres for a movie are stuffed into the same column. To analyze by genre, we need to split the genre column. We use comma followed by a space as the delimiter, and we split into rows rather than columns. Now, each movie is split into multiple rows, one for each genre it belongs to. To get each genre into its own column, we have to pivot the genre column. Excellent. Now we have columns for each genre. If a movie belongs to a particular genre, its gross earnings will be in the column. If it doesn't, the column will contain null. We assign all of the earnings of a movie to each genre it belongs to. This is an approximation, but as long as we're consistent, this should be fine. Now, we just need to group by decade and sum up the gross amounts for each genre we care about. Okay, we have our results. The table is minimal and easy to upload, and it has all the data we need for our graph. If I try to upload it using MondayLink right away, I'll get an error. This is because I haven't defined an underscore name column, which MondayLink uses for item headers. Instead of adding one in Excel, I'm going to specify it in Power Query. I'm just going to use the decade column for item headers. Now let's upload the table as a new board. The results are in Monday.com, and we can now create our chart. We can extract any number of insights from the source data. Now let's focus on the top grossing movie of each decade. I'll start by duplicating my existing query, because that already has the calculation for the decade column that I'm going to need here as well. I'll get rid of the other steps after that one though. I want to know the top movie of each decade, so I need to start by grouping by decade. I don't want to aggregate the data, I want to keep all of the rows for each decade. Next, I want to rank movies inside each group by the gross revenue field, and then later, I'm just going to pick the first movie of each group. Before I can do that though, I noticed that some of the newer movies don't have a gross amount at all. Since we can't rank them by gross revenue, we'll just get rid of them. I'll insert a step to do that. Once we do that, we lose the movies in the 2020 decade. Since we don't have the revenue data for them, we just can't use them. Now let's get back to ranking movies in each decade. We can do that using the addRankColumn function. The input table is going to be the table we have in the movies column. We're going to be ranking the rows by the gross column in descending order. And we're going to be using ordinal rank to resolve ambiguities in the unlikely case that we have multiple movies with the same exact gross amount. We can skip the last parameter if we want, it's not likely to make a difference here. Okay, that gives us a rank table of movies for each decade. Now we just need to expand this column and pick just the movies whose rank is equal to 1, so we're left with just the top grossing movie of each decade. Once we have the rows we're interested in, we can get rid of all of the temporary columns we used, as well as any source data columns we don't care about. Perfect. That gives us a nice and clean data set that we can publish to Monday.com and use to plot our chart. Before uploading, we have to pick a column to use for item headers, and I'll just use the decade column for that. Once the data is in Monday.com, we can chart the top movies of each decade. But instead of making the chart on this board, we'll probably want to make a dashboard so we can see all the metrics in the same place. Since these boards only serve to populate the dashboard, we can tuck them away into a folder or even a separate workspace. Unfortunately, we can't copy a chart from a board into a dashboard, so we'll have to recreate the first chart. And now we can add a new chart for the top movie of each decade. We can use a bar chart to plot the gross revenue of the top movies. Unfortunately, charts in Monday.com are fairly limited, and the bar chart doesn't let us see which bar represents which movie. A simple way around it is to use a stacked bar chart, and stacked by the name of the movie. This isn't really going to stack anything, since we only have one movie for each decade, but it will give us a tooltip and a legend that will tell us which bar represents which movie. If we stack by the director, the color coding will let us know if we have the same director in multiple decades, which we do since James Cameron had the top movie in the 1990s with Titanic, and in the 2000s with Avatar. Okay, now we've uploaded the data, but what happens if we get a fresh version of this data source? Easy, we can just refresh the Excel tables with Power Query and then upload the fresh results into Monday.com using MondayLink. Let's simulate this by exaggerating the gross earnings of The Shawshank Redemption, directed by Frank Darabont. Step 1 is to refresh the tables in Excel, and step 2 is to simply upload the fresh results into Monday.com using MondayLink. And we can easily see the change in the dashboard. Let's correct the number and upload the changes again. and now the dashboard is as it was before. So to summarize, if we want to show metrics from other systems inside Monday.com, we have to process the data elsewhere and upload the results into Monday.com. Each graph we make is likely to need its own board, so we're probably going to be collecting the graphs in the Monday.com dashboard. The process I outlined here is partly automatic. It requires some manual intervention on the part of a user to refresh data. It's not a process that can run on its own, unattended. A fully automated pipeline with incremental updates is outside the scope of this video, but if this is something you're interested in, please let me know in the comments of this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please leave a like and a comment, and consider subscribing to this channel for more content like this.